Hi there, my name is Chantelle. Welcome to my channel. Soon, it's going to be the saddest day of the year. So today, I thought I'd show you 5 art ideas to have fun in your sketchbook and conquer the January blues. We're not aiming for anything incredible, we're going to have fun. For the first idea, we're going to be using negative space. Choose a simple shape, this could be anything, I'm going to do flowers. I'm using tape to create a lovely border around this painting, it's not essential but it does give a more finished look. For the first layer, you can use any colour of paint, I'm going to be using pink, blending into purple and blue just because they're really fun colours. And we're going to slowly fill in this background, leaving the shapes that you've decided on. Once the entire background is filled, we're going to leave that to dry and move on to the second layer. For the second layer, you can really approach this however you like. We're going to paint in the background again, and it's completely up to you whether you want to go around each of the shapes and leave them white, or colour over them so they're a slightly lighter shade. Another thing you can do whilst filling in the background is to add more shapes. I added small ones at this point because I had no space left on my page, but you can do whatever you like. Whether or not you use one colour or lots is completely up to you. And finally, use a hairdryer and gently remove that tape. It's essential if you don't want any tears. Negative space is a really fun technique. You can use any colour, any shape, and it helps you relax. Moving on to the second idea. We're going to paint a plant and I chose a monstera. I'm using watercolour paint but you can use any medium for this idea. The first step is to lay out the shape of the plant. Again, you can choose any subject for this idea, but choosing a leaf will help you focus on the individual patterns you see and it's a really calming experience. I decided to add a little bit of a background around the edge of my leaf just to provide some shape, but that's completely up to you. For the second step, you're going to want to grab a pen. I'm using a white Posca for this. We're going to add patterns all over the leaf. I did squiggly lines, but you can do whatever you like. It's a really fun experience, and this is such a quick idea. You can easily fill the sketchbook page in under 5 minutes. Moving on to number 3. This idea, we're going to paint an animal. I'm using a similar method to the one that I used in my first 5 sketchbook ideas, which I'll leave down below if you missed it. We're just going to wet the page and add some paint. I decided to go for a lion because a fluffy animal generally works better for this idea. I'm making the face a little bit darker to bring dimension, and then I'm going to leave that to dry. Next, you're going to want to grab some colour pencils. You can also use pens or pastels. Because we've got the base layer down, all you need to draw is a cute face. I would definitely use a reference for this. I'm giving my lion a cute cartoony look and that's the entire piece done. This is super simple, but how can you be sad when you've created something so cute? The fourth idea is really cool and you've probably never tried it. We're going to be using cling film. Today I'm using watercolour. I've actually never tried it with acrylic and gouache. I should give that a go. Very simple, we're just going to paint the shape of a leaf in green. I found a leaf works best for this method because the effects the cling film give look very similar to the patterns on a leaf. Now that the leaf is painted, you're going to want to grab some cling film and just scrunch it up in your hands. We're going to gently press the cling film onto the leaf. Make sure it's scrunched up and it's not flat because that's where the patterns will show. And when you're applying this, make sure to be gentle as it's very easy to get too close to the edges and accidentally smudge the paint. Press the cling film down and then we're going to leave it to dry naturally. It does take longer than usual. Once it's dry, you can just peel it off. And at this stage, you could call it complete, but I decided to add some messy line art. I'm going in with a black Posca. And I'm really loosely lining around the leaf and adding in some stems. That's the idea done, and look at these patterns up close. How fun and unique are these? There's no other way to create them like that. The final idea is super simple. It's a messy doodle style page, but it's really fun. I'm using watercolour for this, but you can use any kind of paint. The first thing we're going to do is wet the page. Then we're just going to drop different colour paint all around the page. It can be really calming to watch the paint spread and the blooms form, and it can really get your mind off things. Once that's dry, you can grab literally anything and draw doodles over the splodges. Pens, colour pencils, pastels. I'm using colour pencils and drawing stars because I find them so fun. But you can draw whatever your imagination sees. You're not going to create a masterpiece with this idea, but it's super fun and it's a great way to quickly fill a page. And that's the five ideas done. You can use your art supplies to create incredible pieces, but it's also important to remember to just have fun, and that's what these art ideas are for. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you've enjoyed. I would love to know down below if you would try any of these pieces. It would mean so much if you could subscribe, and I'll see you on Sunday with a new video. Bye bye.